Sono Today, the Tripuran State Party is organizing hunger strike for realization of three demands, for achievements of three demands. Firstly, creation of a state consisting of Tripura Tribal Areas Autonomous District Council, namely Tripuran State, under Article 3 of Indian Constitution. This particular demand is being raised due to historic reason. In the past, we have seen when Tripura marched with India on 15 October 1949, and in the post-merger, when the first population census of India in her post-independence in 1951, we have seen that the host population of Tripura, 20 communities of the state had been reduced to minority within 2 years from the date of murder with India. And thereafter, the influx of refugees from the then East Bengal, erstwhile East Pakistan, and now Bangladesh had been continuing till 1971, and thereby the host population, which was having 93% of the total population, was reduced to minority to 28%, and now there was little bit increase. It is said to have been increased to 31%. In the post 1971, where there was Indira Mujib Pact with cut-off date 24th March 1971, even thereafter, there were lot of illegal migration into the state, and illegal migration into the state from Bangladesh is taking place every day. Therefore, the existence of the host population in Tripura is threatened, and they are on the verge of extinction. If all the illegal migration, if the population of illegal migration is added to the total population of the state, the percentage population of the host population, percentage of the host population would be reduced to 11, 12, 13% like that. That will be there. Now, if Citizenship Amendment Bill 2019, which is figuring as serial number 16 of the business list, which is being placed before the two houses of the parliament in this winter session, which will be having cut-off date 31st December 1914, and it means that Tripura will have more population pressure after the post Citizenship Amendment Bill 2019. Therefore, we oppose Citizenship Amendment Bill, and in order to save this 20 host population in Tripura, it is required that the tribal areas autonomous district council areas should be elevated to a full-fledged state, the Prolan state, under Article 3 of the Indian Constitution, without which they are going to face extinction in the future slowly and gradually. To mention it in other words, Tripura is the only state in India the population of which got reduced to after merger with India, and this reduction was due to refugee influx owing to partition in 1947. So granting of statehood is the only alternative before the host population in Tripura state. Lastly, the Bru displaced persons camped in Kanchanpur at different places who are actually from Mizoram. They have spent their time in Tripura after being displaced is about 22 years. It is more than two decades by now, but the settlement or rehabilitation of these displaced persons, of these displaced Bru people from Mizoram, are yet to be settled in an appropriate manner. Recently, there was stoppage of ration to these displaced persons from Mizoram. However, the rationing has been restored to them. Our demand is the rationing, the supply of rations to these displaced Bru people should not be stopped until and unless they are appropriately rehabilitated either in Mizoram or in Tripura. Because about 35,000 displaced Bru people, many of them were from Dumbur hydroelectrical project areas who were ejected due to these projects. So this is one part of the displaced person. Another another part, another section of displaced persons of the law was from Mamid district. Mamid district was part of princely state Tripura, which was given away to Lusai Hill in the year 1874 for containing Kuki rebels. So this Mamid district, in this Mamid district, there were Bru people living and residing in Mamid district right from the time of the princely state, which was the then part of princely state of Tripura. Therefore, Mamid district is also a home of Bru people only. That's why we are demanding.